Good morning, class 8. Now we are moving on to our lesson 5, natural and man-made disasters. Now what is a disaster? Anything which occurs suddenly, any sudden disaster, any sudden event, any calamitous event which occurs suddenly and which causes a lot of human or environmental or economic losses is known as a disaster. So this disaster may be man-made or natural. Natural disasters are disasters like earthquakes or volcanoes or any other thing which is occurring naturally, or nuclear explosions or accidents. So these come under man-made disasters. Disasters may sometimes be reduced to some extent. For example, natural disasters. Natural disasters, if we are taking care of Mother Earth, they can be reduced. Man-made disasters, these are what we are doing for ourselves, so it is mostly in our hands. So this disaster can be managed with the help of disaster management, right? Disaster management is nothing. See, when some calamity happens, most of the people, they come in groups and they help each other. That is only disaster management. Helping each other, individuals or groups. Some groups will be there, like voluntary groups, or some government individuals will be there. Government corporations will be there. So all these, they will be helping. So this is disaster management. When we are in need, we help each other. That is disaster management. And what is the need for disaster management? Now only we have seen what is the need for disaster management. When we can't help ourselves, someone is coming and helping us. And who is that someone? Who is that someone? Government organizations? Voluntary organizations, all these are helping others, helping the people who are in need. The basic aim of disaster management is to reduce and avoid the loss from hazards and help the people who are suffering from disasters, right? Now these are the phases of disaster management, that is the steps involved in disaster management. The first one is mitigation, that is minimizing the effects of disaster management. So when we know that a disaster can occur in case of man-made disasters, for example riots or floods. So when we know that if a place is in a low-lying area, we can move the people, we can evacuate the people to another place. So that is mitigation. We can minimize the effects. Next one is preparedness. Planning how to respond. If at all a flood is occurring suddenly, so how the people can respond. Next one is response. Efforts of reducing the hazards. How the hazard can be reduced. How the hazard can be reduced in case of emergency, how the people are responding. So sometimes mock drills are conducted. So how people can respond in case of a disaster. Next one is recovering. If at all a disaster has occurred, how people will be responding to that situation. That is recovery. So these are the phases of disaster management. Now we are going to see the first type of disaster, natural disaster, flood. What is a flood? A sudden rise in water is known as flood. When a flood happens, a lot of human loss happens and a lot of economic loss also happens, even environmental loss happens. So that is why a flood is known as a natural disaster. So before a flood, when we know that a flood is going to occur, we can evacuate the people to some other place and we can move them to a safer place. And when we know that our area is in a flood prone area, please build barriers or leaves so that it is easy to stop the flood. And we have to listen to the radio, we have to switch off all the electrical appliances, and we have to keep a medical kit always ready in case of older people are there in the house. So we have to keep all this ready. During a flood, we should not walk in water. If at all we have to walk in water, we have to walk with the help of a stick. Why? Because all the electric wires and all, they will be put off in water. If at all the current is passed, then it will be a life risk. So that is very much dangerous, right? Then after a flood, what we have to do? We have to boil the water and we have to take care of ourselves very much. Why? Because water-prone diseases will be spreading up very fastly. So these are all the things what we have to take care of. And next one is earthquake. Earthquakes means a sudden trembling in the earth's crust. This happens along the fault lines, and when the magnitude is so much high, that happens to be a earthquake. Generally, if we are inside, when we are inside the earthquake, we should not be under beams or even windows. We have to be very safe. If at all you are driving, you have to stop driving at once, and we should not enter any kind of old buildings, or we have to see that we are not touching any kind of electrical wires and all. So most of the fire accidents, they happen because of carelessness only. 60% of the fire accidents, they happen because of bad wiring. What we have to do in case of a fire accident and what we should not do in case of a fire accident, now we will see. As in case of other natural calamities, we have to evacuate the place and we have to pull the fire alarm. And one more thing we have to do is we have to keep our head low so that we need not inhale a lot of smoke. So what are the do's in case of a fire accident? First thing we have to do is we have to be very careful with the electrical wiring. We have to see that the elder supervision is necessary in case of children. We have to switch off all the main wires, main switch, and we have to see all the ISI certified appliances are being used, right? And what are the don'ts? We have to see that there are no substandard fixtures and there are no temporary joints, and sometimes the joints will be kept under carpets and all. So that should be avoided, right? The country has different administrative machinery at different levels, like district, state, Zilla Parishads. Every level it is having administrative machinery in case of a disaster. But the central government sees to the whole thing. Under the central government, the Ministry of Home Affairs, is responsible for the disaster management. And under this, we have another apex body which is known as National Disaster Management Authority, NDMA. Policies and plans which are related to disaster management, or the they will be laid down by this NDMA. Okay. As far as the district is concerned, deputy commissioner or the district collector is responsible for all the present activities. Apart from these, apart from the government organizations, so many voluntary organizations like clubs, Lions clubs and all, they help the government organizations. NCC, NSS, all these, they help the government organizations in case of a disaster. Now we are going to see the first case study. Floods in Assam and Bihar. This is caused by the confluence of two rivers. One is right side, Brahmaputra River, and left side, tributary of Ganga, Kosi River. So Kosi River is also a very big river. Brahmaputra River is also a very big river. These two rivers, they cause lot of flooding near Assam and Bihar. Right? Kosi is also known as the sorrow of Bihar. So why this is causing a lot of flooding is both the states are in a low-lying area. So when these are in a low-lying area, these rivers, they bring in a lot of silt while they are coming. So this silt is being deposited here. It's not washed away. And so it causes a lot of flood. Mostly, you have a lot of rainfall in 3 months. In the monsoon months, you have a lot of rainfall. And that also is one cause for increase in water over here. And one more reason is population, increase in population. That also is a reason. And next one is effect of flood. Effect of flood is soil erosion. Soil erosion. And because of degradation of land, the land is totally damaged. And when Brahmaputra floods are occurring, most of the animals, they are forced to come into the human areas, right? That is the effect of floods of Brahmaputra and Kosi. And the second natural calamity what we are going to see is the earthquake in Nepal, which occurred on the 25th of April in 2015 with the magnitude of 7.5, and because of the collision of the tectonic plates. When there was a collision of the tectonic plates, it occurred for 6 times, causing a lot of tremor. Right? And most of Nepal depended upon tourism, and lot of tourist places were destroyed. And moreover, people of Nepal, they depended on as tourist guide, and what all crops also, what all crops, what all food they have stored, everything was destroyed, and most of them, they suffered from wash related diseases, that is water related diseases. Animals were affected, places were affected, hospitals, many hospitals were affected. People, if they had to go to a hospital, they were affected, right? So these are the effects of a earthquake. Landslides were happened. Landslides, already it is a mountainous area, and the soil will be very loose. And after an earthquake, the soil became more loose, and the place was affected more. And the next case study what we are going to see is oil spill in USA, which occurred in March 1989 in Alaska. So this is the spill of liquid hydrocarbon into the sea or marine areas, any marine areas. When liquid hydrocarbon is spilled on the sea, the hydrocarbon, it stops the oxygen which is going into the water. So fishes, they die of no oxygen. And birds, when they when the petrol or oil, it puts on to their wings, the wings, they become very very heavy, so that they cannot flap their wings, right? So birds also die because of not flapping their wings, and moreover the temperature of the birds increases, and the plankton which is inside the sea also die because of no oxygen. So in order to avoid all this, we have to reduce the oil which is being consumed. How we can reduce this? We can use a sharing, carpooling, like that. We can use it, and we can reduce the amount of oil being used. right? Hope the lesson is understood. Thank you.